I move adoption of resolution 15-6, Seth World Trade Center. The text of this resolution can be found beginning on page 24 of the official delegate information booklet.
Does the sponsor have any changes or corrections?
Madam President, the sponsor has no changes.
Thank you. Mr. Treasurer, this resolution is adopted. What is the cost of the institute?
The scope of required effort is difficult to define, but expected to require a substantial commitment of both staff and financial resources for expert forensic consultation and the resulting lobbying efforts to take this action.
Mr. Secretary, what is the board's position?
Madam President, the board does not support this resolution. This resolution would effectively put the Institute on record as questioning the validity of the National Institute of Standards and Technologies investigation and the report on the collapse of the 7th World Trade Center on September 11, 2001. I would also seek Institute support. It would also seek Institute support for a new investigation. Tragic events that occurred on September 11, 2001 have had a profound effect on all of us. The causes of the collapse of World Trade Center towers buildings were studied and reports were prepared by the National Commission on Terrorist Attacks upon the United States, also known as the 9/11 Commission. The National Institute of Standards and Technology and the Structural Engineering Institute of the American Society of Civil Engineers. A panel commissioned by AIA's president in 2014 found every reason to rely on the credibility and findings of the 9/11 Commission and all of those expressed in the SEI, ASCE, and NITS studies, and saw no reason for further investigation. The board agrees with that view.
Oh, now we're using a timekeeper.
AIA from Houston, AIA Houston, and I thank you for allowing me to speak. In July of 1981, at the Hyatt Regency Hotel in Kansas City, Missouri, a fourth floor walkway collapsed onto a second floor walkway. Both of these walkways were crowded with people watching a dance competition. For a year, that accident, that catastrophic accident, was studied until a definitive report was made explaining why those walkways collapsed. And in the process, the lobby of that hotel was closed. No such study has happened for World Trade Center 7. In 2001, September 11th, World Trade Center 7 collapsed at near freefall speed at 5:20 in the afternoon. There were several small fires in the building. It was not a raging fire. This was the third steel frame building to collapse on that day. It was also a fire road to steel frame building. World Trade Center 7 is 47 stories tall. Collapsed in 7 seconds. Why did it collapse? It was not hit by an airplane. There were minor fires. The 2008 report by NIST, National Institute of Standards and Technology, said that normal office fires caused beams to push a girder off of its seat on a column, ultimately causing that column to bend and collapse, and therefore the building collapsed at near freefall speed, symmetrically into its own footprint. Every one of us who is an architect in this room, and most of us are architects in this room, know that that is not possible.
Amen.
Things like that do not happen. 10 years, it's time for a real investigation into why that building collapsed. If, in fact, a small office fire, which is what this said, a normal office fire, caused the building to collapse, then every steel building in this country is in danger of collapse. Okay, thank you very much.
The floor is now open for discussion of Resolution 15-6. Chair recognizes that Mike on the floor.
My name is Frank Pitts. I represent the Eastern New York chapter, and I'm the Vice President of AIA. Ladies and gentlemen, in this resolution, we are being presented with a wolf in sheep's clothing. The resolution before us appears to be benign. The makers ask us to support a reinvestigation of the collapse of World Trade Center Building 7 on the basis that it was not acceptable for a simple fire to bring down a modern steel building. If that were possible, then we must change our codes. But that isn't what they actually need, but the real object that they hope for. One finds a particular concern expressed in the alarming language and material presented in support of this resolution on the floor of the Convention Center and at the website of the current organization, Architects and Engineers for W911 Tree. Their narrative leads a reasonable person to a conclusion that they believe that the collapse of these buildings was the result of a controlled demolition involving charges placed in advance of the collision of airplanes in all three, in Towers 1 and 2, and that this was aided and abetted by a cover-up conspiracy on the part of the government of the United States and others. The sponsors of this resolution cannot have it both ways. A panel of your elected representatives was appointed last summer to consider this request. I chaired that panel. Members of the panel will be addressing you. The panel's findings strongly endorse you voting no on this resolution. The fire department arguments presented are merely a pretext to get us to agree to an investigation that becomes a vector for their true purpose, a study that rejects the current official conclusions. We support the current official conclusions.
Call
this
him on.
Business before us
call
has nothing to do with the American Institute of Architects.
Did you state your name and chapter? Sorry, when you first started.
Yeah, he did. Of course he did.
Gage, AIA member of the North Ironfield chapter and founder of Architects and Engineers for 9/11 Truth. 8 years ago, I became aware of one of the most serious high-rise failures in modern history. I was shocked that I had not previously heard about it from any of my colleagues or on the news, but by listening to a local radio interview. This morning, we have the opportunity to collectively call for the first impartial technical investigation into the collapse of 47-story high-rise World Trade Center Building 7, the third skyscraper to collapse on 9/11. It was destroyed on the afternoon of 9/11 at 5:20. It fell suddenly, symmetrically, into its own footprint at free fall acceleration in under 7 seconds. The structural frame was completely shattered. In order for a building to fall symmetrically, all of the columns must be compromised at once. Otherwise, the building will fall over. In order for the building to fall at free fall acceleration, which NIST blindly acknowledged in 2008, not one column could have given any resistance in the building. And yet, we were told 7 years later in the final NIST report that this building came down due to normal office fires, which were in fact few, small, and scattered. But fires have never brought down a skyscraper before or after 9/11. The AIA has yet to weigh in, as we did with the Twin Towers. So far, during the course of this convention, we've had more than 115 AIA members visit our booth, review the collapse, and sign on with the 2,355 other architects and engineers who are calling for a new investigation of Building 7. You are not alone. More than about 90% of design professionals who have reviewed the evidence have also called for a new WTC 7 investigation. How many signatures does it take to compel action, the moral and ethical obligation of the AIA to look into this collapse? Thank you.
Number four.
I'm Donald King, and I'm Director, Northwest Pacific Region, Representative on Strategic Council, and at-large Director-elect to the Board. This resolution we're discussing now is, it's not about building codes, and its basis is incorrect in its interpretation of a 797-page NIST report on World Trade Center Building 1, after Building 7. That collapse of that building, according to the report, was caused by massive intensive fire and the collision of debris from the collapse of World Trade Center Building, or Tower 1. It was an extreme fire and structural damage that caused the collapse of World Trade Center. This, as I said, is not a resolution about codes. This is an attempt to draw the AIA into a position statement to legitimize the opponent's conspiracy theory that we really begin to get into another study on the World Trade Center complex collapse altogether. If their theory is true, that this is a widespread conspiracy of the government and others, then this is an illegal act. This is a criminal act.
It is.
The murder of thousands of people.
What?
This should be taken up by law enforcement, not the AIA. I urge you to vote no on this resolution. Thank you.
It's video. Video.
My name is Richard Wallace. I'm a member of the Chicago AIA, and I'm also honored to be one of the 55 architects who signed this petition. The theme of this convention this year is impact. How can we, as architects, as AIA members, have the meaning of impact? Community and on society. As architects, there's one quality that is inherent in our personal makeup, a quality that is a key feature in our profession, and that quality is integrity. Integrity is what we design into our buildings. Integrity is what drives us to design these beautiful structures all over the world. Integrity is also what causes us to flinch and cringe when we drive by a digital strip mall. But as architects, we also carry a heavy burden. We have all kinds of responsibilities. We have social responsibilities. We have legal responsibilities. And we have moral responsibilities. We have responsibilities to Mother Nature, to our environment, which we are continually modifying to meet our needs. When we decided to join the AIA, we volunteered to take another important responsibility. On top of all our other responsibilities, we joined the AIA to be elected to be held ethically responsible for our actions.
Your 2 minutes is up.
I'm sorry?
Your 2 minutes is up. Thank you. Well, Chair, I think I'm just microphone four at this point.
Thank you, Madam President.
I don't really know what you're talking about.
I am a member of the AIA group chapter. On 9/11/2001, my office was on the 21st floor of 2 World Trade Center. I lived through that experience, and at an emotional level, I please ask you to let us move on from that day. It is time for us to move forward. That building collapsed. The building collapsed because of a raging fire caused by 6,000 plus gallons of diesel fuel that fed the New York City Emergency Response Center.
That's not true.
You need to admit that to yourselves.
There's no evidence.
And I'm urging the Institute to go no other resolution, and I respectfully request to hold the question.
That was a lie.
More than the 2 hours of the fire
protection in the building, and yet it collapsed fully and symmetrically. That doesn't make sense. What we are asking the AIA to do is to call for a new investigation, an investigation that is impartial, that is non-political, that is unbiased, that is fully funded, that is done by professionals. And that has not happened with this building. It needs to happen. It needs to be done in a professional way. We, as the delegate from Florida said, we are a professional, not a political organization. But in this case, if we vote no on this resolution, we are making a political decision, not a professional one. Thank you very much.